Good morning, class.
You are welcome to this class today. Today we are discussing about factors of agricultural production. What are the factors that is affecting production of agricultural products? And also, we are going to look at the meaning of the production and these factors that affect the production of agricultural products as an enterprise. Firstly, when we are talking about production, what do you understand by production? Production is the process of manufacturing goods and providing service in agriculture to satisfy the community. During the process of production, there are some factors that we need to bring together or to combine together in order to make production to be successful. And these resources, these factors are very, very important. There is no one that must be left out in the production of any agricultural products on the farm,
either at the animal sector or at the crop sector. These factors that we are going to look into are very, very important. What are these factors? Number one, land. Number two, labor. Number three, capital. Number four, management or entrepreneur. We are going to look at them one after the other, how they are very important in the production of agricultural activities or products. When we are talking about land, land refers to a place where productive activities such as growing of crop, rearing of animals, and establishment of farm building are being carried out. Mostly all our production are taking place on land. And under land, we can also discuss about water, which we are still coming to it. Because some agricultural activities, we make use of water in performing all those activities. So that is why land include the soil that you are using, the mineral in the soil, the water body, and the vegetation. All this, we see, if you look at them, they are embedded in what we refer to as land, and they are free gifts of the nation. They are given to us by what? By God. That is why land is referred to as free gift of nation, and it is fixed in supply. That you cannot change the size of land, or you cannot move land from one place to another. A particular area or measurement of land that you acquire is what we have. Years to come, years after year, it cannot increase and it cannot decrease. But it can just be depreciated in value, which you can also appreciate. And from there, we are looking into importance of land in agriculture. What are the importance of land in agriculture? Land is used for cultivation of crops. We make use of land to cultivate our crops. Crops like rice, maize, yam, etc. We also use land for rearing of animals, different livestock, rearing of goats, rearing of cattle, rearing of pig, rearing of fowl. We make use of land to rear all these animals. Land can also be used for forest development. We use land for forest development, that is planting of forest resources, like planting of big trees that we use to construct roads, to construct buildings, or where we derive all our plants. They are cultivated, they are planted in the world, in the forest. Land can also be used for fish pond development, that is the development of fish pond, construction of fish pond, where we use for rearing of land. It is used for wildlife conservation, it is used for cultivation of cash crop, e.g. cocoa, coffee, rubber, and land is used as a collateral for securing loan from bank. That is all about land. Now, the second factor is labor. When we are talking about labor, labor include all productive human effort, all the effort of woman to carry out production that he put in production, either mental effort or physical effort. Mental effort in the sense of supervision. You know, you employ some people to supervise your farm. They give instruction, they give advice. They tell you where to go, what to do, what to produce, and what to do to carry out at a particular period of time. You employ their mental effort. You employ their mental effort to carry out production. Why physical production, physical effort is the using of laborers to work on the farm. Those people that are working physically on your farm, your poultry attendants, your cultivator, the person that is cutting the grass or planting the grass or planting the crop, they are under labor, and you use them. If there is no labor on your farm, production will not be effective. Production will not be effective. Labor can be in two forms. But before we go into the forms of labor, let's look at the importance of labor. What are the essence of labor? Why do we need to employ labor? It is use other factors of production. Labor use other factors of production. They work on the land. They make use of the money as your capital that you use on the farm. They make use of all your farm inputs. They use other factors of production. Intellectual labor ensure high agricultural production. That is, when you employ a labor that is highly intellectual, you will see the results on your production. Skilled labor provide the expertise required for major operation. And labor ensure the success of any agricultural enterprises. It provides the service required to achieve your aims. As I've said, that we have two forms of labor. We have skilled labor and we have what? We have unskilled labor. Under unskilled labor, we have your family, yourself, under unskilled labor. Why the skilled labor? We have those people that are what? That are higher labor. Those people that you hire, those people that are intellectual, they have the intelligence to carry out your production activities on your farm. Another factors we are looking into is capital, which is money. Capital is all man-made productive assets which are used in the production. That is all what you use, all what we have, bring it into your production. At the beginning of your production, in form of money, in form of material, in form of building, in form of seed, all these things that you are bringing into what, into production at the beginning of your enterprises, at the beginning of your production, is what you refer to as capital. And it can be either fixed capital, which you also refers to as asset capital, or variable capital or working capital. Now, when we are talking about fixed capital, they are the capital that they are fixed. You use them for a long period of time in on your farm. Even after that season production, for the next season production, you still make use of them. They are assets to you as a farmer. Example, farm building, motor vehicle, farm tools, and implement or land labor, land furniture, incubator, implement, machines that you use on your farm, they are referred to as fixed capital or fixed asset. The second type of capital is working or variable capital. These are the capital that you use for a period of time, for a particular season. You use them, and for the next season, you require from another one, or you use them for a certain period, a certain season, or a certain period of production. They are referred to as working capital. For instance, water, drug, feed, cash in hand, fertilizer, seed, chemical, all these are not for a long period of time. You use them within a season or a particular period of production. What are the characteristics of capital? Capital can be appreciate or depreciate. Some are mobile, e.g. tractor. We have the man-made an accumulator over the year. Capital stock can be improved through saving or borrowing. Reward of capital is interest. Let me tell you, the reward of land is rent. The reward of capital is interest. Now, another factors of production. Okay, the reward of labor is wages or salary. Wages or salary. What's different between fixed capital and working capital? Fixed capital are the items or material that you use for a long period of time. even after production. You use them during and after production. Why working capital is a capital that you use. You use them up during process of production. That is, you finish using them during production. Fixed asset is durable. Why working capital is not durable? Fixed assets do not change. They do not change form during the process of production. Why working capital can change? And examples of fixed assets, fixed capital are motor, building, farm tools, implement, land, furniture, incubator. Why examples of working capital are water, drug, feed, cash in hand, fertilizer, and seed. Importance of capital in agriculture. Working capital is used day-to-day running on the farm enterprises. You use the capital to run day-to-day. You want to buy goods, you want to buy things from the farm, to the farm. You make use of capital. Working capital is used for paying wages. Working capital is used for paying wages, and is also used for purchase of farm inputs. Fixed capital in farm fixed capital in form of farm machinery provide farm power operation, and fixed capital can also be used to generate fund and so on and so forth. Now, we want to look at water. Water is very important when we are talking about production in agriculture, and it's part of land, as I've said. It's a free gift of nation, and it can come in any form, either as a rain source, it can come from well, and in the form of stream or what or ocean. The importance of water in agricultural, in agricultural production is that we use it to mix material, building material when we are constructing farm building. Water can also be drank by man, the farmer himself on the farm, and also by the animal. We use water to water, in watering, supplying irrigation to our seedling. And water is used for processing of some farm produce. For example, if you want to process your cassava on the farm, you use water to wash and you use water to soak. It is used for washing of tools, equipment, machine after use. Your water can be used for rearing of fish, and also this one of the nutrients that is necessary, that is needed for the growth of plants. The last factors of production we are looking into is entrepreneur, or what we call management. This refers to the person or a group of people who are organized. They coordinate, they control the use of other factors of production on the farm. It can be an individual or a group of people that are available to control, monitor, coordinate, organize other factors of production. And this is the person that is responsible for direct affairs of the farm administration. The reward of entrepreneur is interest. What is the importance of entrepreneur or management in agricultural production? Number one, it coordinates and control other factors of production, as I've said earlier on. It takes decision about the farm business, what to do, what to produce, where to produce, who to sell to. They take decision. It manage the farm business in order to make profit. It look into what and what to do in order to make profit. It determine the level of payment of wages and salary. Management influence the organization, and the quality of management influence the output of the business. And you can see that all these